Oh, I need to lie down.
Hello everyone, I'm Mr. Scott. Welcome to Distance Learning PE. We're going to do another movement session together today. So we're going to start out by loosening up our bones, loosening up our joints. Then we're going to warm up our bodies. Then we're going to keep our brains guessing with a game. Then we're going to do a workout to help us get stronger. And then we're going to cool down with a bit of stretching. Let's get started. Each time I'm loosening up my body before I start moving, I like to use the same sun salutation flow, the Sunny Sally flow. That helps me feel when I'm getting stronger, when I'm getting more flexible, when my balance and coordination's improving. Let's do it now. So we start, just like last time, with our hands together above our heads, standing up nice and straight, and we push our hands against each other. Push, 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 push. And then flop down, keeping our hips high and our shoulders low, and doing the same sound. That'll help us relax. Hips high, shoulders low, and make that sound. Then we put our hands on our shins and push our shins and push our shoulders back behind us. Push, 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 and flop again. Hips high, shoulders low, make that sound. Then we put our hands down on the ground and feet back like we're about to do a push-up. And we lower down as slow as we can. The slower you lower, the stronger you'll get. When you get down to the floor, keep your hips low, put your shoulders high. You could look up a little bit if you'd like to. Then put your hips high and your shoulders low and make that sound again. Then pick up your right foot and put it high in the air like a donkey kick. And then bring your right knee to your chest, right foot high, right knee to your chest, right foot high, and right foot in between your hands. Put your hands straight up in the air above your shoulders and lean your shoulders back just a little bit. Drop your back heel on the ground, left hand back, right hand forward. Look at your back hand, look at your front hand, look at your back hand. Put your front hand high up in the air and your back hand on your back knee, looking up at your top hand. Then cartwheel just with your arms back down to front support, like you're about to do a push-up, and lower down as slow as you can. Nice and slow. When you get to the bottom, keep your shoulders high and your hips low, looking up a little bit if you'd like to, then push your hips up in the air, keep your shoulders low, and make that sound. Then pick up your left foot, high in the air like a donkey kick, and bring your left knee to your chest, left foot up in the air, left knee to your chest, left foot up in the air, left foot in between your hands, hands straight up above your shoulders, lean your shoulders back just a little bit, and then drop your back heel, right fingers back, left fingers forward, look at your back fingers, look at your front fingers, look at your back fingers, look at your front fingers and put them high up in the air, back fingers on your back knee, looking up at your top hand. And cartwheel just with your arms back down to the ground, into push-up position, lower down as slow as you can. Nice and slow. Straighten your arms, shoulders high, hips low. Push your hips up in the air, shoulders nice and low, and make that sound. This time, we're lowering our knees. Keep your shoulders low, hips high. Lower your knees, tap the ground, and back up. Tap the ground, and back up. Tap the ground, and back up. This time, we're going to jump like a frog so that our feet replace our hands. Have a watch. Then you put your hands together and put your elbows inside your knees and lower down your wrists so that your forearms become nice and horizontal. Pushing your knees out. Very nice. Pull your hips side to side a little bit, just gently. Remember, we're loosening up our joints, ready to exercise, ready to move. Then put your toes together, heels together. Hands high up in the sky like we did before, and push, push your hands together.
Now keep pushing while you start lowering them down, nice and slow. Pushing, pushing, pushing. We're waking up our shoulders. And when we get lower, we'll start waking up our chests, our big chest muscles. When you get in front of your chest, you should be able to push really hard because your chest muscles are strong. And then flop down, everything shakes, shakes, shakes. Well done. Now that we're a bit looser, we're going to warm up our bodies. We're going to do some exercises that get us puffing. We're going to do 5 exercises and we're going to use that magic number 11 while we do it. The first exercise involves us looking like scarecrows. You're going to put your arms out and you are going to keep them out no matter what. Sometimes I'll tell you to put your fingers up. Sometimes I'll tell you to put your fingers down. Sometimes I'll tell you to make little circles. Sometimes I'll tell you to make big circles. Sometimes those circles will go the other way. Sometimes I'll ask you to keep your elbows where they are and just rotate your forearms. That one's tricky. And the other way? All right, keep them out no matter what. Fingers up, fingers down, fingers up, keep them there. Now we're gonna do some lunges. We're gonna do 11 lunges while we hold our arms out. Lunges look like this. One foot stays where it is. The other takes a big step forward and then lowers down so that your knee almost taps the ground and then it comes back. Let's do one more. Down, keep those arms there and back. We've done 2. Let's point our fingers down now. Keep them there. 2 more lunges. Good job, there's 1. Another one. Good job, we've done 4. Now we're going to start making little circles and we're going to try and lunge at the same time. Keep those circles, the little tiny circles. Lunge number 5. Lunge number 6. Lunge number 7. Hold them still. Fingers up. Let's do some more. Lunge number 8. Lunge number 9. Lunge number 10. Keep those arms out. We're going to do big circles. Keep your elbows there. Big circles. Well done. And lunge number 11. And relax. Have a bit of a shake. I can definitely feel them nice and warm up the top there. That's for sure. The next exercise is going to use my drink bottle. You don't have to use a drink bottle. You could just use a cup. You could use a pillow. You could use a teddy bear. It doesn't matter. I'm going to put it right here on the ground in front of me and I'm going to stand behind it. Now, we're going to take our toes, both of our feet to one side, 1, 2, back behind the drink bottle, 1, 2, to the other side of the drink bottle, 1, 2. Each time we go next to the drink bottle, we're counting that as 1. We're going to do it as fast as we can. Ready? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Now I'm starting to puff. The next one we're going to do is going to use our calf muscles behind our shins. So we're going to be popping up in the air. But we're not just going to pop, we're going to do a crisscross pop. I'm just making names up now. Crisscross pop. So we're going to crisscross and then back and then the other leg in front, kind of like a grapevine. Ready? We're doing it 11 times. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Golly. Let's let's keep our breath puffing. We're gonna run on the spot, but we're gonna lift our knees up as high as we can while we're running. Ready? For 11 seconds. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. I think I was counting a bit fast at the start there. Way too excited. Last exercise is our big favorite of a lot of people. Not really. It's called burpees. What we're gonna do is, we're gonna jump up and clap. Then we're gonna go down and be a mini man. And we're going to kick our legs out. So we're in a push-up position. We do a push-up. We go mini man, jump and clap. We're doing 11. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Last one. Oh, 11. I'm definitely warm now.
This time, we're gonna play a game of chairs without any chairs. Let's have a look.
So in this game, the easiest position is standing up, nice and easy. There's heaps of positions though. Each position is gonna use a different chair. We're just gonna sit on a normal chair like we would at our desk or at the dinner table. A normal chair, our hips are about the same height as our knee. We're just gonna sit on this invisible chair. Maybe we could read the newspaper, we could have our dinner, try to sit up nice and straight, it's tricky. Sometimes we might sit on a little chair, like a step, nice and small. Sometimes we might sit on a stool, which is a bit taller. Just have our bottom perching on a stool. Sometimes we'll sit down cross-legged. And sometimes we might even jump up in the air. Now jumping up's gonna get hard with all these invisible chairs because standing up is easier than sitting on an invisible chair. It's the opposite to a chair that you can see. Normally when I play this game, we take turns with the leader, but seeing as we can only hear me, I'll just be the leader today. So, doing as I do, doing as I say. Standing up. Sit at a chair. Nice work. Read the newspaper. Maybe read your favorite book. Good job. Stay sitting on that invisible chair. Okay, now a little chair. Nice small one. On a stool. Very nice. Nice and relaxing sitting on this invisible stool. Back to a chair. Jump up. Sitting cross-legged. Very nice. Crossing your legs. Good job. Back to the chair. Back to the chair. Mini chair. Stool. Well done. Mini chair. Stool. Very nice. Standing up or have a little rest. That's nice. Back to the chair. Back to the stool. Jump up. Back to the stool. Back to the mini chair. All this sitting down is hard work. Back to the chair. Back to the stool. Cross your legs. Jump up. Have a stand, have a little rest, that's nice. Back to the stool, back to the mini chair, cross your legs, back to the chair. Very nice work. Back to the stool, stand up, mini chair, jump up, mini chair, stool, mini chair, mini chair, cross your legs. Well done, everyone.
I can't stop them. I can't stop. I can see but you when you dance, dance, dance. Feel good, good creeping up on you. So just dance, dance, dance. All those things I shouldn't do, but you dance, 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 dance. Ain't nobody leaving soon, so keep dancing.
Okay, time to get stronger. We're going to do a workout. We're going to do three exercises. We're going to do each exercise for 1 minute. The first exercise, I'm going to use my drink bottle. You don't have to use a drink bottle. You could use empty hands. You could use a pillow. Anything that you can hold or hold an imaginary something. It'll work just fine. I'm about to start the timer. I'm going to start doing it while I explain, while I'm showing you. You get started as soon as you understand. Let's try. 1 minute has started. We're going to sit on our bottoms and we're going to lean back and lift our feet off the ground. My feet are off the ground. Then I'm going to tap the drink bottle down here and then tap it on the other side and keep twisting my body. Tap, 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 tap. I could just do it with empty hands tapping the ground. I could do it with a pillow. Keep tapping. We're just past halfway. Keep tapping, keep tapping. The drink bottle's a little bit heavier, so I might get a little bit stronger. I'm still leaning back. My legs are still in the air. Balancing, balancing. Well done, everyone. A quarter left. I can see that red sliver shrinking. Keep twisting, keep twisting. My tummy muscles are really feeling tired. One more. Well done.
Good job.
Let's reset this timer. Okay, ready for the next one. Here we go. The next one, we are going to be balancing while we get stronger. We're going to get the back of our legs stronger. We're going to dip like a drinking duck. So, I'm standing up nice and straight. I leave one leg straight on the floor and I lift the other one up, still keeping it straight, my body straight. I lean down and I tap the ground. That takes a lot of balance. Then I switch to the other leg. Whoa. This leg needs more practice. Back to the first leg. Trying to keep a straight line between my foot and my head. Keep dipping. Tap the ground with your fingers, come back up. Tap the ground, whoa. It's tricky to stay balanced. Try and keep that leg that's holding you up nice and straight. Well done, everyone. A quarter of the way left. I can see that red piece of pizza disappearing. Maybe someone's hungry. One more. And well done, everyone. I can feel the back of my legs nice and warm, getting stronger. Now, just trying to reset this timer. Okay. We've got our 1 minute. Our last one is going to use our arms and our chest. We're going to get stronger arms and stronger chests. Follow along. I'm going to go down in a push-up position. Then I'm going to go as close to the ground as I can without touching it. And I'm just going to stay there. Nice and close to the ground. Oh, I'm tired already. But I'm going to keep trying as hard as I can. If you do need a rest, you can drop down for a second and then pop back up as quick as you can. Just have a couple of breaths and then get back up. Oh, geez, I'm tired. I can feel my shoulders shaking. I don't know if you can see it. Boy, I'm feeling really tired. Oh, golly. Oh, the sliver's gone red. There's not much time left. I think I can do it. Oh, it's really hard. A couple more seconds. Well done, everyone. Well done. Good job, feeling strong. Good job today, guys. It's time to warm down. What I'd like you to do first is on your knees, I'd like you to put both hands up in the air like you've won a race. Nice and high. You'll see my back is even arching a little bit. Nice work, I've won. I'm the fastest ever. And then I want you to keep your arms up
and I want you to flop forward so that your knees are touching your chest. Keep your arms up, keep your arms up. You can put your forehead on the ground a little bit as well. Just relaxing and letting your back stretch out. That feels really good. I can feel the back of my shoulders stretching. Then I want you to keep your head and chest where it is and bring your arms down next to your body, next to your legs. My hands are touching my feet. I'm just letting my back relax and stretch out like a little baby lying on its belly with its legs curled up. We're going to stay here for 5 more seconds. 4, 3, 2, 1. Well done. Sitting on your bottom, legs out in front of you. Bring one leg up and put it on the other side of the opposite leg. And then hug that knee that's across your body all the way up to your chest. Try to straighten your back so it pulls your leg up off the ground. This foot's off the ground a little bit. I'm sitting up nice and straight and I'm pulling this leg with me. I can feel the back of my leg stretching nicely because I'm hugging it so tight. And then put it down. Now we don't want this leg to feel left out, so we're going to switch over. And this leg gets a hug as well. Give it a nice big cuddle. We don't want it feeling sad and lonely that it missed out. Straighten your back up. See, this foot's off the ground a little bit because I'm hugging it so tight. We're going to do it for 5 more seconds. 4, 3, 2, 1. And shake out your legs. Shake out your arms. Well done, everyone. Have a drink.
Oh, I'm so tired.